Hello everyone, welcome to our channel IAC Steno. We are starting the passage at speed of 80 words per minute. Start. The Nobel Prize in Chemistry for 2020, which was announced on October 7, Wednesday, has two women scientists as its recipients. That in it is a first in the sciences, Emmanuel Charpentier, a French microbiologist working at the Max Planck Unit for the Science of Pathogens in Berlin, Germany, and Jennifer A. Doudna, a biochemist from the University of California, Berkeley, U.S. shared the honor for the development of a method for genome editing discovery. Likely omissions, the two scientists have pioneered the use of CRISPR clustered regularly interspaced short palindromic repeats, CAS9 CRISPR associated protein 9 system as a gene editing tool. In a short period of 8 years since its discovery, the method has already made a significant impact in biology, medicine and agriculture. It is not often that one sees practical applications of scientific findings in such a short time. The only other work with such a quick and revolutionary impact is PCR polymerase chain reaction, invented by Gary Mullis in 1983. The Nobel Prize as the most coveted prize, especially in science, often attracts controversy. This year too is no exception. The discovery of CRISPR can be traced back to 1987. This was when a group of Japanese researchers observed an unusual homologous DNA sequence bearing direct repeats with spacing in a eobacterial gene. Several important discoveries followed. In subsequent years, Francisco Mojica, Rodolphe Barangue, Luciano Marafini and Eric Sonthimer discovered CRISPR and showed it to be a bacterial adaptive immune system and to act on DNA targets. A notable discovery on the use of CRISPR as a gene editing tool was by a Lithuanian biochemist, Virginijus Sikinis, in 2012. Sikinis showed that CAS9 could cut purified DNA in a test tube. The same discovery for which both Charpentier and Doudna were given the credit. Thus, the conspicuous exclusion of Sikinis from this year's Nobels, especially when the Nobel Prize can be given to three individuals, the will of Alfred Nobel has it that the prize can only be shared among a maximum of three individuals is going to raise discussions. This is especially noteworthy when Cycnes, along with Charpentier and Dodona, shared another coveted award, the Kavli Prize for Nanoscience in 2018. However, the Nobel Committee recognized Charpentier and Dodona as the sole discoverers for programming a CAS9 protein to cut a piece of DNA at a specific site with the help of a small piece of RNA, thereby proving the ability of CRISPR CAS9 to function as a gene editing tool. Other notable early contributors to the field that many believe deserve mention are Feng Zhang of Broad Institute of MIT, Harvard, and John Church of Harvard. Feng Zhang, a past postdoctoral fellow in Church Lab, and Church himself, the named inventors of many genome science method, have made several early contributions to the field. These notable exclusion may raise controversy, but Church described the reason for the exclusion best. He saw it this way, that Charpentier and Dodona made a discovery, which is what the committee prefers to reward, and he and Zhang were inventors. In the male-dominated world of science, this year's Nobel Chemistry Prize should be widely celebrated worldwide. The recognition that Charpentier and Dodona's work has received will encourage women to take up science as a career. Despite the hard struggle to balance family life and an arduous life in a scientific career, although CRISPR became a household name for its ease of use, other systems discovered before CRISPR can cleave DNA at specific sites, an example being the zinc finger nucleases in this Dana Carroll, who developed the system, is another notable exclusion from this year's Chemistry Prize. It would have been an excellent and befitting reply to all who say that women cannot compete with men in science if the Nobel Committee had named Carroll alongside Charpentier and Dodona. In India, there is a long way to go before realizing that utility of gene editing for therapeutic applications. That said, we cannot be complacent and wait for a rogue individual or entity to try it out in humans. The world was alarmed by such a mission in 2018 when the Chinese scientist He Jiankui edited genes in a human embryos using the CRISPR CAS9 system that was subsequently implanted and resulted in the birth of twin girls. He claimed this was ostensibly to prevent them from contracting HIV, and the incident became known as the case of the first gene-edited babies of the world. Following a global outcry, the World Health Organization formed a panel of gene-editing experts, which said a central registry of all human genome editing research was needed in order to create an open and transparent database on ongoing work. It is called upon WHO to start setting up such a registry immediately. In India, several rules, guidelines and policies backed up by the rules for the manufacture, use, import, export and storage of hazardous microorganism, genetically engineered organism or cells, 1989 notified under the Environment Protection Act, 1986 regulate genetically modified organism. The above act and the National Ethical Guidelines for Biomedical and Health Research Involving Human Participants 2017 by the Indian Council of Medical Research and the Biomedical and Health Research Regulation Bill implies regulation of the gene-editing process. This is especially so in the usage of its language, modification, deletion, or removal of parts of heritable material. However, there is no explicit mention of the term gene editing. Stop.